It's very important, I think, not just in media, in any circle, to be very, very careful who is in your inner circle.
That's so true. I always say, you know, it's big network but tight circle. You know, that's so important.
Yeah. And so I've learned so well how to compartmentalize people. Like, you are a colleague.
Yeah.
You are a close friend, you know? And so you need to have, I have about four friends, two of whom are my sisters, so they don't have a choice. And they will call me out. I need people who can call me out.
Accountable to.
Yeah, right, and they can be like, what is this you're doing? Stop it. And I know they mean well. Not yes men or people who are there for the ride.
But I think that's such a good point, because I think each one of us needs to ask ourselves, who are we accountable to?
Yeah.
And, you know, are the people that are in our circle telling us the truth? Are they being honest with us? Are they saying, actually, what you did sucked? Or, you know, are they just saying, oh, you were amazing all the time? And I think that's really important. The people that I have in my circle are just, you know, amazingly frank and honest with me.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's really painful, but I don't know what I'll do without
them. But you know they mean well.
They have my back. You know, and that's
they mean
well.
Thing. So when you're dipping, they'll be like, I don't like where you're going. And so you come back because you trust them. But nowadays it's just a whole mentality of, it's social media friendships.
It is.
I followed you one day and now we're BFFs.
Exactly.
We've never even met.
I mean, I'm sure you get this. I'm sure you get this all the time, where people who follow you or whatever meet you and they're like, hi, like long lost friends, and you're like, oh, and I'm like, I'm not sure. But people just have this, the familiarity is incredible, right?
It's crazy. And you don't know somebody's journey. You don't know their character. You know what I want you to know.
Yeah, exactly. Because it's out there. What you want me to know is out there.
You know, so it's just knowing that. But even in the journey to knowing yourself, you will feel uncomfortable when you're doing something that's not true to yourself. You will feel the highest level of emotional discomfort.
But I think you will. But I think you have to be quite sensitive to feeling that, because I think a lot of people go through life without thinking. They're just like, it's you know, it's so fast that we just have to do what we have to do today and tomorrow. Very few people actually reflect. Very few people sit down and introspect, you know. So I think the people that do will soon realize that something's not sitting right, or I'm not, and I've felt that quite often, is that because I spend a lot of time just by myself, you know, thinking and introspecting. And sometimes I can even have a client that, you know, I'm like, it's fine, because they're, you know, they're paying us, and then I'll go back and I'll introspect and say, you know what, I just don't feel good about that.
Yeah.
And then I'll come back and say to my team, you know what, guys, I've thought about it, and they'll be like, but, you know, and I'm like, no, but and I think introspection and, you know, just reflecting and spending time alone is so important.
It's so important. It's so important to always, and I do the same thing even in my brand. You'll have different people calling you up as you start rising and you get a sort of following. They start calling up, but if your brand values are not aligned with my brand values.
Exactly.
And I'll tell you, we don't have to hate each other.
People judge you by the company you keep.
Yeah.
Right? And I think that's really
And I'm
key.
Not going to, I don't, it's no hard feelings. I wish you well, but I'm not the brand for you, you know?
And you know what? It's not one size. I mean, you know, not everybody's going to fit, right?
Yeah.
Not, it doesn't have to be. And I have friends that I really like, but they're not people I'd work with. You know, they're like different people to bring different things to your
compartmentalize.
Life. Compartmentalize. Yeah, exactly. There you go. Yeah. But you know what, Adelle? I think, you know, just as an organization, and just to see you rise has inspired me. Oh. Because you know what? It just makes me feel just proud. And your mother, whom I loved, just so dear. And when you got your recognition the other day, I thought about her and I thought, wow, here was Mary, who was this amazing woman and who just loved you to bits. But she would just be so, so proud of what you've achieved.
Yeah.
And so, you know, as hard as it is that she's not here, to be here and appreciate and to recognize you, I know that she is smiling down and she's looking at you and she's saying, yeah, that's my girl.
Definitely. I felt the same way when the news came in, because I mean, when my mom passed away, I was very, it was like destabilizing, like, whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, so now what do we do? And I was smack in the middle of radio, just 2 years in. And, you know, she used to negotiate all my contracts in the back.
Which,
like,
did.
Go back and tell them this.
Yeah.
So I go back and be like, I think I'm worth.
Yeah.
And not having her then, having to negotiate my Radio Africa contract alone.
Grow up, right?
I had to grow up overnight. And so for a while, and I was thinking about it this week, for a while I was trying to emulate her. And I was so uncomfortable, so uncomfortable. I was like, I have to keep doing these things. I have to get this breast cancer awareness up there. And then what I realized, I was like, but that was her journey.
Absolutely.
And you what know what? Is yours?
I don't think she'd want it any other way.
Yeah.
I don't think she was looking for a copy of Mary.
Yeah.
You know what? I think she just wanted Adelle to be Adelle.
Exactly.
I think sometimes, and you know, I've lost both my parents too. And I think we do so much in our, you know, what we think they would want us
exactly.
to do.
Exactly.
You know? And so I think at some yeah. point you have to take a step back and say, actually, you know, I think they'd just be
they
happy
want me to be
with
me.
Me being me.
Yeah. You know? So then this week, then I was like, yeah, she's definitely happy because this is definitely like my own madness
exactly.
that brought me here.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So you know what? I am so proud of you.
Thank
I am
you.
Going to be following your journey as
Thank
I have
you.
Done ever since you were here.
Yeah.
And you know, I know that we will probably end up doing something great together.
Definitely.
And shape the conversation mm-hmm. in this country on sexual violence towards women.
Yeah.
I would love to be part of that journey. It's something that I really do think is a problem in Africa.
Yeah.
And so whatever I can do in my small way, in my African travels, let me know, because I would really, really love to shape that particular conversation on the continent.
Definitely. I will definitely reach out, because the conversation has got to be had.
Like, oh, it really does. Absolutely
yeah.
does.
Hi, everyone. My name is Adelle Onyango, and you're watching Shaping African Conversations.
Hi, it's Gina Din-Kariuki, and you're watching Shaping African Conversations. This afternoon, we've had Adelle Onyango, who started her journey at the Gina Din Group. I hope you are inspired by her. I know I am. If you liked what you watched, please share it, please like it, and please engage with us. We would love to have more conversations with you. We're so excited we're doing this series, and thank you so much for your time.